Hello and welcome back to Travel in Chinese. I'm Mark Rosewell, also known as Dashan. In the last episode, we followed Xiaojie and Liu Yong to the fitness center. They had a lot of choices to make. They could go to the 健身房, the exercise room, or the 游泳池, the swimming pool. 他们可以打保龄球, they could go bowling, 也可以打乒乓球, or they could play some ping pong. 今天真过瘾, today is really satisfying, they said. Well, today we're going to follow Xiaojie back to the fitness center, this time with her aunt. Let's see what they choose to do today.
Xiaojie,过来歇会儿吧。累了吧？昨天和表哥玩的怎么样？表哥带我去健身中心打了乒乓球，你猜谁赢了？让我猜猜，是表哥吧？
不是，是我赢了，真会赢。看你这么得意。当然了，那你今天还想去打乒乓球吗？不想去了。对了，你喜欢游泳吗？<笑>喜欢啊，游泳可以减肥。据说经常游泳还可以使人变得更聪明。真的吗？健身中心那儿就有游泳池。我知道，我昨天刚去过。
我今天还要再去游，那我跟你一起去吧，我很久都没游泳了。可以呀，你带游泳衣了吗？没有，这可怎么办呢？没事，健身中心有卖的，我们可以到那儿买一件。太好了，我们走吧。走。运动。小杰，你看，这儿不是有很多游泳衣吗？
让我看看，都挺漂亮的。嗯，您好，您好，我们想买一件游泳衣，一个泳帽，
还有一个泳镜。嗯，好。游泳衣您要哪一件？小杰，喜欢哪一件？
我喜欢那件蓝色的。
来，给您东西，谢谢。来，小杰，咱们走。嗯，
那里边的游泳池大吗？是标准池，有50米长。有潜水池吗？走吧，
进去看看就知道了。小杰，这边是潜水区，那边是深水区。我还是先在潜水这边游吧。
小杰，到我这边来游吧。你那边的深水有多深？
2米左右吧，过来试试。我游泳的技术不太好，不敢到太深的地方去游泳。要不再给你买个游泳圈？我还是先试试吧。啊！小杰，小心！
这不游得挺好的吗？ Okay, now let's go over the dialogue part by part. Xiaojie mentions going to the 健身中心, the fitness center. 健身房 would be an exercise room. 健身中心 is the whole center, including a gym, perhaps a swimming pool, and other rooms. 猜 is to guess. 你猜谁赢了? Guess who won? 让我猜猜. Let me guess. If you just can't guess, you could say 我猜不出来. I can't guess. 看你这么得意. Look at you, so pleased with yourself. 得意 is often used in a negative sentence to be complacent, to be conceited.
你别太得意了. 谁赢还不一定呢.
Don't get carried away. You can't tell who will win. It hasn't been decided yet. So 得意 is often used in a negative sense, but it can also be used in a positive way as well. Like 最得意的学生, favorite student. 最得意的作品, favorite work or some kind of composition that you're most proud of. In the dialogue, 得意 is meant as a friendly jab. I know you're happy, but don't get carried away.
昨天和表哥玩得怎么样?
表哥带我去健身中心打了乒乓球，你猜谁赢了?
让我猜猜，是表哥吧？
不是，是我赢了，真会赢。
看你这么得意。
当然了。
They decide to go swimming. 游泳可以减肥。You can lose weight by swimming. 减 literally means to subtract. For instance, 三减一等于二。3 minus 1 equals 2. Well, here, 减 is short for 减少, to reduce. 肥, fat. 减肥 is to lose weight. 据说, it is said, or I hear. 据 is short for 根据, literally means according to. 据说, it is said. I hear that swimming can even make people smarter. 据说, 游泳还可以让人变得更聪明呢。变得 is to become.变得更聪明 become more intelligent.
那你今天还想去打乒乓球吗？
不想去了。对了，你喜欢游泳吗？
喜欢啊，游泳可以减肥。据说，经常游泳还可以使人变得更聪明。
我昨天刚去过。I was just there yesterday. 过 is used after a verb to indicate that the action happened in the past and was already completed.I've been there before. 我去过。Adding 刚 indicates that this was very recent. 我刚去过。I was just there. Today we're going to be looking a little bit more at this pattern. Verb plus 过。我今天还要去。I still want to go again today. 再去。Go again. 还要再去。Still want to go again.
健身中心那儿就有游泳池。
我知道，我昨天刚去过，我今天还要再去游。
我很久都没有游泳。I haven't gone swimming for a long time. Here, 都 adds a little emphasis. You could say, 我很久没有游泳。It means roughly the same thing. I haven't been swimming for a long time. But it lacks the emphasis of, 我很久都没有游泳。Also, by adding the 都, it indicates that you would like to swim, you miss swimming. Without the 都, it's just a statement of fact. You may not miss swimming at all.
那我跟你一起去吧，我很久都没游泳了。
可以啊，你带游泳衣了吗？
Unfortunately, 小杰 hasn't brought her swimming suit. 这可怎么办呢？ Here, 可 and the 啊 ending are used to add emphasis. 这怎么办？ What can be done?这可怎么办呢? Means the same thing, but it's much more emphatic. They can buy a suit at the fitness center. This is one of those times when the tones are most important, because 卖 is to sell, and 买 is to buy. 健身中心有卖的。They sell them in the fitness center. 可以到那儿买一件。We can buy one there.
没有,这可怎么办呢?
没事,健身中心有卖的。我们可以到那儿买一件。
太好了，我们走吧。
那儿不是有很多游泳衣吗？ Now we're going to look at this pattern today using the 不是 something 吗 pattern to ask a question. This is used when the answer to the question is obvious or when you think you know the answer already.
不是吗? Isn't it so?
这儿不是有吗? Don't they have them here? You might ask this when you see something right in front of you. In this case,The meaning is more like, what did I tell you? Here they are. They're going to buy a 游泳衣, a swimming suit, 泳帽, swimming cap. We could also say 游泳帽, 泳帽is perhaps more common. And 游泳眼镜, swimming goggles. 眼镜 are glasses, but in this case, we would probably say goggles in English.
小杰你看,这儿不是有很多游泳衣吗?
让我看看。都挺漂亮的。
嗯。
您好。
您好，我们想买一件游泳衣，一个泳帽，
还有一个泳镜。
嗯，好。
游泳衣您要哪一件？
小杰，喜欢哪一件？
我喜欢那件蓝色的。
The swimming pool is standard size, 是标准的。It's standard, 50 meters long, 50米长。浅水区 is the shallow end, the shallow area of a pool. 浅 is shallow, 深 is deep. For instance, 浅水, shallow water. 深水, deep water. We can use these two characters together to indicate the depth. 深浅, the depth.
那里边的游泳池大吗?
是标准池，有50米长。
有潜水池吗？
走吧，进去看看就知道了。
我游泳的技术不太好。I'm not a very good swimmer. 游泳的技术 is skill at swimming. I'm not a very skilled swimmer. 小杰 doesn't dare go to the deep end, so perhaps they should head back to the shop and buy a 游泳圈 a round floating aid like a life-saving float. But her aunt says, 她这不是游得挺好吗? Isn't she swimming quite well? Again, here she uses the 不是something 吗 pattern.Indicating a rhetorical question. The answer is obvious to see. Let's take another look at that now.
小杰，到我这边来游吧。
你那边的深水有多深？
2米左右吧，过来试试。
我游泳的技术不太好，不敢到太深的地方去游泳。
要不再给你买个游泳圈？
我还是先试试吧。
啊。
Let's take a look now at a specific language point that came up in today's dialogue. 据说, according to, it's said, or I hear. Here's an example. 据说去上海的机票很便宜. I hear that the plane tickets to Shanghai are really cheap. 据说去上海的机票很便宜. Here's another example. 据说他会说好几门外语。I hear that he can speak many foreign languages, or several foreign languages. 据说他会说好几门外语。
对了，你喜欢游泳吗？
喜欢啊，游泳可以减肥。据说，经常游泳还可以使人变得更聪明。
Now let's take a look at some of the grammatical patterns that came up in today's dialogue and do some substitution exercises. Was followed by 过。That indicates that the action happened in the past. Now the negative would be 没 verb 过. We never say 不 something 过. For example, I could say 我没说过. I never said that. I wouldn't say 我不说过. That would be incorrect. Let me show you an example.
你看过京剧吗?
Have you ever seen Peking Opera before?
你看过京剧吗?
Okay.Let's try some substitutions now, using verb plus 过。
你吃过北京烤鸭吗？
你吃过北京烤鸭吗？
他去过很多国家旅游。
他去过很多国家旅游。
Let's look at another pattern now.不是 something 吗? This is a way of asking a question when you already know the answer. You're just asking for a confirmation, like, is it not true? Or, isn't it so? For example,
去长城的车不是早上六点开的吗?
You know that the car or train leaves at 6 o'clock in the morning. You're just asking to make sure. Isn't it true that the car or train to the Great Wall leaves at 6 in the morning?
去长城的车不是早上六点开的吗?
Okay, let's try some substitutions with this pattern now.
这件衣服不是你的吗?
这件衣服不是你的吗?
你不是已经去过上海了吗?
We hope to keep receiving your emails and letters with comments and suggestions.You know, we'll be selecting some viewers who write to us and inviting them to come and take part in our review lessons. Okay, we look forward to seeing you next time.